Okay, in this video, we are going to calculate limit as x approaching infinity of x root of x. Of course, this right here is crazy looking, but it's not that bad if you change this to the rational exponent form. So right here, we can actually write this as the limit as x approaching infinity. And remember, whenever we have the index of the radical, this becomes 1 over x power. This number is the denominator of the exponent, but it's a rational number right here, right? A rational exponent. So we can just pretty much do this. And if you are like now, you can plug in infinity into this x and that x, and we will see that we will have infinity for the base raised to the 1 over infinity's power. This right here, we can draw a conclusion. This right here is approaching 0. So we have infinity to the 0's power. And the problem is that this right here, it's an indeterminate form. We cannot draw any conclusion yet unless we do more work. So let's do the work, right? And notice the base right here is a function, and the power right here is also a function. So I want to introduce a natural log. And the style of doing this is that I will just call some number, let's say L, to be this limit. So I just write this down. This is the limit as x approaching infinity of x to the 1 over x power. And I will take the natural log on both sides. Technically, I should put it right here on the outside. But when you take the natural log of the limit, it's the same as the limit of the natural log, because natural log is a continuous function. So I'll just put it right here. And once we have this natural log, when we have this power here, I can just actually take this to the front. But don't subtract 1. This is just the natural log property. It's not the power rule for the derivative. Anyway, this right here is the limit as x approaching infinity. Here we have natural log of x, and when you have the 1 over x in the front, 1 times this, this is still on the numerator, this x will go down to the denominator. So we have this over x like that. So once again, the 1 over x in the front, if you put it like this, 1 times ln x is ln x on the top, and then the x is in the denominator, so this is really nice. So this is pretty much what we have. And if you now plug in infinity into here, we see that ln of infinity over infinity. And the deal is that ln of infinity goes to infinity, and then of course the denominator is also infinity. Well, here, infinity over infinity, even though this is an indeterminate form, but this is L'Hopital's rule, ready form, right? So I will just be using the L'Hopital because we have infinity over infinity. And I will just be differentiating the top and also differentiating the bottom. And we see this is the limit as x approaching infinity. The derivative of ln x is 1 over x over the derivative of x is just nicely equal to 1. And now I will plug in infinity here. And we have 1 over infinity right here. This is something that we can draw a conclusion. So 1 over infinity, we know it's 0. But 0 is not the answer to this, because we said ln L is 0. I had to find out what L is. So of course, you can just say, okay, this is what we have. And we can just do e to this power on both sides, right? E to that power as well. In another word, L, which is, you can write this down or you can write that down, up to you. Perhaps just to impress people, I think this is more impressive form, right? So let me just write that down. The limit as x approaching infinity of x root of x. This right here is e to the 0's power, namely 1. And here we have it. Yeah, this is the answer.